Can I, Victoria Vian, really do that? Go on the internet and just start spreading lies? Yeah, I can. None of these things are real, but they are pretty silly. Here are 10 very not actually true theories about Splatoon 3. Let's go. The real reason they took away the laser from chargers in Splatoon 3 wasn't to make them stronger, but actually it was just to prevent players from having laser light shows in squid parties. This way, Turf War can return to being all battles, all the time, just as the development team intended. Inkbrushes and Octobrushes are no longer a part of the game. You know why? We see that Nintendo has taken a lot of time to redesign the Dynamo Roller, showing they're focusing on improving the better half of the roller class. On top of that, we see a jellyfish actively painting in a cutscene during the Splatoon 3 trailer. This can only mean that jellyfish have stolen all of the remaining inkbrushes for themselves, forcing the inklings and octolings of Splatsville to adapt to an environment that lacks part of the roller class, the brushes. But how is that inkling even sitting there? Like, in the snow? Snow is water. Everyone knows inklings melt in water. Get that child out of the snow right now, or else they're gonna melt! They're gonna melt, I tell you! There is a scene in the trailer dedicated to the player character throwing Little Buddy to give him a snack. I think Little Buddy's ability to eat the mammalian ink is why you're able to style his hair so easily. After all, the hair he's eating has to go somewhere, right? The outfit that Callie is wearing in the trailer is way too cold for the environment. This can only mean one of two things. Either the snow is fake, or Callie and Marie are fake. And you know what? I think I'm leaning towards it being the second thing. As the title suggests, Splatoon 3 is gonna be a game where we get back tri-squad battles. However, because 4 isn't divisible by 3, that also means we're gonna be losing 4-player league battles. Ah well, that's why private battles exist. Okay, hear me out. What if there are humans? But they're secretly controlling Inkling society through mind-controlling Judd and Little Judd. However, it's not for a real malicious reason. It's just because the humans are inside of Judd and Little Judd's brain. As a last-ditch effort to survive, maybe a group of scientists shrunk themselves down teeny-tiny and entered inside of one of Judd's fluffy, cute ears. But by the time the first Judd was created, the technology used to shrink the humans was also gone, so they couldn't change back to normal. Now, every single time a new Judd is created, the shrunk down humans are also recreated, allowing the species to keep on surviving. Do you think an inkling could strap an entire crab tank to themselves and use it as an ink tank? It's in the name. It fires giant blobs of ink. It's gotta keep the ink somewhere. Come on, who's gonna try it first? The addition of the Zipcaster, a special that allows the player to turn into a ninja and zipline across the map, may have been directly inspired by the January 2016 Europe and Oceania Splatfest Barbarian vs. Ninja, where the Barbarian team managed to win with only a 23% vote. Maybe the development team all picked Team Ninja and they still wanted to get a win. In their own way. By, you know, putting ninjas in the game like that. While some may believe the addition of fully functional feet to the members of the Octarian army was to symbolize an attempt at evolution, the real reason is much simpler. We all know that Inklings, Octolings, and Octarians alike all have difficulty moving forward through enemy ink. With such precise, small feet, the Octarian army may be able to move through any type of ink with ease to engage in combat during the Splatoon 3 hero mode. Ink resistance? Nah, you just need little tiny feet. Alright, you can take off the tinfoil hat now. You did it. You survived. Hopefully none of these ever come true. Smash that sub button for more anti-truths. Yeah. If you ever heard someone actually start talking like this, it's probably good to walk the other way. It was fun to make these up though. Thanks for listening and having a little bit of fun. See you later.